And welcome back to Let's Play Life is Strange. Blind, I'm the RPG chick. Now starting episode 3.
In the previous episodes of Life is Strange.
Whoa! It's called film Little Pieces of Time.
Because Max wants everybody to see
I'm
how
so sick of people trying to control me!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
And there she is.
How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories.
Let's talk about your superpower.
Hey, Stelman Louise. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please, step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
Please, get me out of here! Max!
Nobody cares about me. Nobody.
What are you doing here, Max?
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the route with Kate Marsh? Please, tell us everything.
And sign here.
What the hell is this?
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today.
I believe you, Warren. I'll believe anything this week.
So yeah, in this playthrough, Kate Marsh died. We messed that up. But I have pledged myself to remain true to the series that we're doing and not go back and change that. Even though it kind of kills me a little inside. So I'm definitely noticing that these, the eclipse, the snow, the tornado, these are paranormally, at least linked, events. Can't help but see that they have something to do with Max's power. Maybe she's causing them by using her power. Maybe it's due to some other outside force that is causing both the weather changes and her power to manifest in some way. Basically, she's a chronomancer. She can control time to a certain extent, of course. Chaos theory. So I'm looking forward to seeing how all these things are linked together and what it all means. Isn't Dana the one with the bunny? I have something to show you. Meet me in front of campus. Get that ass in gear now.
I knew Chloe would be all over this. So I better get moving.
First,
I still can't stop thinking about Kate.
When did we get the rabbit?
It's like I'm awake in a bad dream. Hey, Bunny. Don't be too bummed, but from
oh,
now
no.
on, I'm your new mommy.
That was Kate's bunny.
Are you hungry, Bunny? Here, nosh on this.
Well, hopefully it won't bring about this being's death.
Sorry, Lisa. Too much water. I can't even keep my plant alive, much less Kate.
We kill the plant? Oh my god. You do anything right?
There's been so much going on, I almost forgot about the eclipse. All this atmospheric action can't be a coincidence.
Ding, ding, ding.
All roads are leading to my tornado vision.
What do we have for her, Johnny? Can't look at the guitar or the clothes like usual.
Come on, Max. No more tears. You have to act, not react.
Can't we cover this or something?
No way can I clean that shit off. Time to get Samuel da Vinci to repaint.
Cover it with a big poster or a blanket or something. Who wants to look at it all the time?
Jeebus, I am so freaking tired. I sound like a moron. But crime does not delay. I need to stay on top of this investigation. Kate, I swear I will use all of my power to find out who really pushed you off that roof.
Yep.
Ew! Thanks for the image, Nathan. And everybody here thinks Samuel is a creeper?
Nathan's the creeper.
You know you're hurting when you don't give a shit about music. How did Sherlock Holmes deduce anything without the internet? Glad the media doesn't waste a second exploiting tragedy. Now Kate's family has to see their daughter's death all over the web like a cat video.
Oh my god.
And I'm even in this one. Oh, that makes me ill.
Blackwell student commits suicide on campus. A student at the prestigious Blackwell Academy jumped to her death today from the roof of a campus dormitory, with most of the student and faculty as horrified witnesses. Authorities confirmed that the victim, Kate Marsh, 18, had been troubled, but more information is scarce at this time. Dozens of cell phones recorded the tragic event, which included an unidentified student attempting to talk the victim down. At least I tried to help. That's something. All the other people sitting there with their freaking cell phones. That is what makes me sick. You gotta sit down there with your cell phone to record her falling.
Besides Rachel, it's been a while since anybody vanished from Arcadia Bay. I shouldn't sound so disappointed.
Rachel Amber, yeah, missing from since April 22nd of 13. Elton Kesley in 01, Melissa Lee Grace in 97, Winston Smith in 84, Sunshine Ray, real name unknown, since 1973.
This is such a moving piece of cut-and-paste Blackwell bullshit. Nobody here had Kate's back. Too little, too late.
What? From Principal Wells, Dear Max Caulfield, as you are no doubt aware, Blackwell Academy lost a valued and beloved student this week with the tragic death of Kate Marsh. Yeah, we were there. Everyone who encountered Kate, from faculty to student body, remember her as a kind, intelligent, and talented person with a bright future. The staff of Blackwell Academy understands the social and academic trauma that comes with a public incident such as this, and we believe it's vital that you hear directly from the students about their thoughts and concerns. We encourage you to call our 24-hour hotline, 1-800-BLACKWELL. If you dial that number, guys, I wonder what we got. To speak with a professional counselor, no matter what your question or situation may be. In other words, Blackwell Academy has your back. They could have fit Academy on one line here. Maybe because it is cut and paste. Formatting issue. Cat videos?
Yes, now everybody loves Kate Marsh. They bullied her and now post their feels? Hypocrites.
Taylor in her heart forever? Yeah, you're responsible for her death, partially, Taylor. Evan Harris, I'll never forget you and never forgive them. Alyssa Anderson, I'll remember your smile. Father Lamont, Blessed are the mourn, for they shall be comforted. Victoria, requiescat, in peace. Is that even spelled right? Mark Brewington, we love you, Katie, the church cries, in all caps. Cody Wagner, I wish we had hung out more. Zach Riggins, Blackwell Bigfoot's promise to win the next game in your memory. Yeah.
Either I delete my page or I block everybody. Nowhere to hide these days.
Time is bunk. Douglas Adams, Epic Fall, Anonymous, Courtney Wagner, Maybe You Shouldn't Have Helped Kate, Zach Riggins, When We Lose a Game, Nobody Dies, Just Saying, Yo, Anonymous, Burn Serpent, Revelation 2010, and The Devil Who Deceived Them Was Thrown Into the Lake of Fire and Brimstone, Where the Beast and the False Prophet Are Also Burn. Victoria Maribeth Chase, Hope You At Least Got a Selfie Out of This. Dana Ward, You're the Only One Who Really Cared, Max. Hayden Jones, Ouch. Juliet Watson, Hey, I'd like to interview when it's convenient, PM me. Anonymous, That Chick Splatted. Oh shit, you dropped her like egg. Oh my god. These people on the inside just feel bad that they didn't do anything to help. It's not even so much they feel bad, but they... I don't know how to explain it. They don't, they see us do good, and, they can't fathom it. Because they don't have that in them, so they just try to, drag us down. I'm sure someone else could explain it better.
Everybody will be talking about Kate now. Blackwell might as well shut down for the next month.
Alright, let's go. Oh, see if there's anything to say about this.
Pretty hard to focus on my class schedule this week. I wonder why.
Alright. Ooh, dark, spooky.
Okay, this is scary dark. Let there be...
Cell phone light? Yep. I have that app, flashlight app. Are we fallen angels who didn't want to believe that nothing is nothing? What's it say? Kerouac, in memory of Kate Marsh. Did I write that?
I hope Kate finally has her wings now.
I guess so.
Where the hell are you, Rachel Amber?
What's that? Oh, shrine for her. That noise actually scared me a little, and I looked this way.
God, that's like some awful TV crime scene in our dorm. Kate, I would give up my power if I could have another rewind to save you. I won't rest until we find out the truth, and somebody pays for this. This is my prayer for you, Kate. Bless your gentle soul.
Aww. So she could have survived another playthrough and all this... Really interested to see another playthrough if all this never happened? That's a lot to have as an, you know... Because if she hadn't died, all this would not be here. This would basically be a scene that's only visible to people who failed to save her. Unless she ended up dying anyway.
So much hypocrite.
Mm-hmm.
The end of the world might be coming before your party.
Yeah, maybe. We have to get caught up with her journal again. Wherever you go, there I am.
That's a depressing thought. And it's always about Victoria.
Mm-hmm. Should knock on her door, wake her up. Avenge Kate Marsh. Brooks. Oh, Brooke. Nothing to say about that one, huh?
the hell are you, Rachel Amber?
Okay, we looked at that already. This is our room. It's spooky, all this stuff. Kinda spooks me. You have to meet up with Chloe. Kate Marsh killed herself. My hands are still shaking, but I have to write this down while I can. Right at the start of Jefferson's class, Kate went to the roof of the girls' dorm to jump. Every student and teacher was watching her like it was a Blackwell rooftop concert. I saw her actually jump, but I was just about able to use my rewind to get her back on the roof. I tried harder than I ever did, and somehow I stopped time completely. I made it to the roof, but again, my head felt like it was going to blow up. I knew that I couldn't just keep rewinding to save Kate. I had to try and talk her down on my own. I failed. She was already in so much pain over the video and all the bullying, so she wasn't going to buy everything I tried to tell her. You see movies with people trying to talk somebody off suicide, but it's very different when I'm the one doing the talking, because she didn't believe me, or maybe she just didn't want to. I tried. Kate still died. It was like that cliche about everything moving in slow motion, except in my case it was real time, not rewind time. I could see Kate's face right as she jumped, and I'll never forget that look in her eyes, like she didn't want to, but had no choice. It was a look of total defeat and despair. Then I could see her body flailing in space, like she became aware of what she was doing, and got more scared. Jesus, I can't believe I'm writing these words. After she jumped, it was so weird that I was alone on the roof. Kate was there, then gone. I could hear the crowd screaming below, and there was no way I was going to look at her body on the ground. I felt so numb, I just casually turned and went back down the stairs. My head was pounding and my body was exhausted from the rewind. I felt exactly like a zombie must feel, dead inside. When I stepped out of the dorm, I saw Kate splayed on the ground. She was surrounded by paramedics while the police kept the students back. I hope they all got a good look at their victim. They wanted to watch her in a viral video when she was alive, and now they wanted to gawk at her in death. Not that I did anything to help her stay alive. All my amazing new superpowers were worthless. I'm nobody's hero. It's not enough that Kate is dead, and I'm numb inside. I had to get the Blackwell third degree from Principal Wells. It was bizarre to be in his tacky office with Nathan Prescott, David Madsen, and Mr. Jefferson calmly talking about why Kate jumped off the roof. Part of me wanted to smash Nathan's smug face against the desk, knowing he had something to do with Kate's suicide. I thought about doing it, then flipping a quick rewind, but I knew that would be the start of a bad, dangerous habit. True. Fortunately, Principal Wells amazingly did the right thing and booted Nathan for a few days. After I told him what happened in the bathroom, he must have more shit on Nathan, because otherwise I doubt this would happen to a Prescott. There's some small amount of justice for Kate. There'll be more if it's the last thing I do, which it could be if I'm not careful. Yeah, I was actually really surprised that he was suspended. I need a vacation from my life. I hung out with Warren on the lawn so I could feel grass under my feet and watch the fluffy clouds. He's such a sweetheart. He kept telling me everything I could do for Kate, even though I know I didn't. He kept telling me I did everything I could for Kate, even though I know I didn't. I told Warren that something ominous is happening at Blackwell Academy. Rachel Amber, Chloe, and now Kate have all been victims, not to mention me, if I keep playing amateur detective. Wish I could have told Warren about my power, but it's not the right time. No pun intended. And to make the day end on the most surreal note possible, the sky went dark and we watched a solar eclipse that was not announced on the news or any astronomy site. What is happening to Arcadia Bay? Here's Kate's messages I read earlier. Hey whore, feminazis will be exterminated, watch out. I remember seeing that one. Warren? Hey, Max. I didn't want to bother you. Just checking in to see how you are. I know today was hard, but you did more than anybody else could have to help Kate. I'm proud of you. And please, no worries about going to the drive-in. But if you want to escape to a planet of apes, let's go. And if you need to talk, I'm always here. XO. Thanks, Warren. I'm still processing. Nathan got suspended, at least. I'll call you later, okay? So the little bios don't change. Hey, honey, I hope you didn't forget to water the plant we gave you. But don't drown it either, Mommy. Max, please call us as soon as you can. We know this is painful and we want to know how you are, so please, please get in touch. And if you want to come and spend some time back home, the door is open and your bed is made. We love you. I'll call you right away. I love you. It was so good to hear your voice. Remember what we talked about. You were there for your friend when she had nobody else, and Kate made her own choice. Nobody could expect more than what you did. You're our hero, and we love you so much, Maxine. Call us anytime if you need to talk or visit. Okay. Are we done with the messages? Here's our little... Oh, can't even see the next ones. So, we're not filling all these up. I mean, we got all but three. I did look for the beakers, but I guess we could only take the picture from before. Warren did his little experiment. That looks like it's at the train yard. Junkyard. And that's obviously at the Blue Whale's Diner. Guess you just have to point everywhere and make sure to click, you know, take a shot or whatever it says.
This is disturbing. Yes, I have power, but Nathan is out of control.
No balls allowed? Somebody's room's open.
I bet you'll party like it's 1999. Assholes.
Why is this always not available? I keep waiting for some monster to come down the corridor or someone with an axe.
I feel like you're guiding us along. But where?
Oh, it's Taylor. Hooray. Water all over the place.
Nobody can blame this poster for Kate's death.
Hey, Max. I saw you go up on the roof to try to help Kate. I can't believe she jumped.
Tempted, but we'll comfort her.
I can. I just wish I could have stopped her. Are you okay?
I'm just, like, numb. I've never seen anybody actually die.
Me neither. I didn't think you'd be so upset considering how much shit you and Victoria gave Kate.
I'm my own person, not Victoria's bitch. Hello, like, she's freaking too.
Okay.
She already broke curfew tonight.
Here we go.
Shit, I'm not supposed to tell anybody.
Once I say that, the bitchy part comes out. So yeah, you've never seen anybody die before. Well, hello, this is the real world. There are consequences for your actions. And, you're the lucky one. Where did she go?
Where did she go?
My lips are, like, sealed. or Victoria will steal them for me.
No doubt.
See you later.
I know I've missed a couple of these, actually. I have to get used to hearing that and seeing the little icon.
Hey, Max.
Comfort?
I can.
I'm just, like, numb.
Me neither.
I'm my own person, not Victoria.
I won't say a word.
I won't say a word. I swear to dog.
Swear to
I
dog?
I hope I can believe you, Max.
I'm my own person, too. See you later.
Huh. So she wouldn't have told us anyway? Maybe if we had blamed her? I don't know. I don't want to keep going back. We erased it.
I hope Victoria feels particularly shitty about posting that link.
Me too.
Victoria isn't here. Maybe I'll just wait and bide my time. Going through her shit.
This is why I don't play horror games, guys. That scared me.
Yes, I am going to find you, Rachel. For Chloe and Kate.
It's just...
Hey, Max?
Oh.
Come here.
Even that scared me a little bit.
Dana's really hurting over this.
Oh, I miss your light. It's way too spooky out here. Can I close the door? Can we look at the paper ball again?
This is both sad and pathetic.
Same thing.
That is so damn cute how much Dana is into this Halloween party. Yes, the Vortex Club does indeed suck.
Is that what that says?
Dana clearly doesn't mind if I peruse her laptop.
Hope not. It's like the third time we're doing it.
Aw, Trevor is a sweetie. Good for Dana.
Trevor. Hey, Dana, I've been thinking about you all day and know how shitty it was to see Kate jump from the roof today. I don't have anything deep or smart to say. I just want you to know that you were a good friend to her, and I wish she had more friends like you. You have been so good for me when everything else is so bleeped up, and I'm here for you always. I miss you, Trev. Dana writes back, thank you so much for thinking of me. I keep seeing Kate jump and feel like I could have done more to save her. Even Max Caulfield did more than anybody to try to save Kate. I can't wait to see you tomorrow, and you are just as good for me as I think I am for you. Brackety smiley face. Dreaming of you tonight. That's cute. That's sweet.
If Dana talks to Juliet about this, she's gonna wish she didn't.
Dana, I hope you're doing okay after today. I don't want to bother you, but I'm writing an article about Kate for the paper, and I wanted to know if you could answer just a few short questions. It seems there are too few answers. Let's talk when it's convenient for you, okay? Hope you're well. Sincerely, Juliet. Hi, Juliet. I know you want to find out more about Kate, but I'm kind of still in shock and mourning. I don't think you'll get too many answers so soon after what happened today, and maybe it's better to keep a low profile for the moment. Mm-hmm. XO, Dana. And now, finally.
Dana looks so sad, even though she's trying not to show it.
It doesn't look like she's trying not to show it.
Hey, Dana. How are you doing?
I just can't stop thinking about Kate. And if this is my fault, too.
Blame Victoria.
Come on, don't blame yourself. There are other people involved, like Victoria Chase.
She definitely deserves a face punch for pimping that video. I didn't do enough to step up.
That wouldn't have stopped her.
Because Victoria was still going to torture Kate with that video.
I know. Kate could have blown it off, but she was too damn nice and innocent.
Dana, there's more to this than just Victoria and the Vortex Club being mean.
So what exactly are you saying, Max? You think this has something to do with Nathan being expelled?
I'm not sure yet.
I'm not sure yet, but I'm on it. Weird shit is going down at Blackwell, and I'm going to find out why.
I'm getting scared now. But people here are still sneaking out tonight.
What? Like, who?
Victoria bounced out of here earlier, and now you, Sherlock?
Not me. I need a break from today. Get some sleep too, Dana. I'll see you later.
Okay. Hate these noises. Juliet, never forget Kate. Why you no pick up my calls? Who wrote the other one? Stella, miss you, Kate. Cry face. My prayers for you, Kate. It's a bumping sound. Oh, wrong button.